isn't about how much horsepower you have but how you use it. Armed with the 603 horsepower version of AMG's twin-turbocharged 4.0-liter V8 engine, Mercedes AMG's E63 S falls short of Dodge's 707 horsepower Charger SRT Hellcat and Cadillac's 650 horsepower CTS-V. The non-SE63, which we don't get in the United States, makes just 563 horses. And yet, thanks to its new 9-speed automatic transmission and 4MATIC plus all-wheel drive, the AMG lays down its lesser output far more effectively than either of those rear-drive muscle machines. Just 3.0 seconds. That's all it takes for the E63 to launch itself to 60 mph. 4 seconds later, the Mercedes is traveling 100 mph. Those acceleration times are 0.4 second and 0.2 second quicker than the 5-pound heavier Hellcat and far ahead of the 458-pound lighter CTS-V, neatly summarizing the benefit of all-wheel drive in launching high-horsepower cars from a standstill. The preposterous list of vehicles that the E63 beats or ties to 60 mph includes Mercedes-AMG's own GTS sports car, the McLaren 570 GT, and the dozen-plus non-turbo 991.2 Porsche 911 cars we've tested. Among four doors, only Tesla's Model S is quicker to 60, and just barely, while the Porsche Panamera turbo ties the AMG but fades behind by the quarter-mile mark. BMW's new 600 horsepower M5 sedan, now also with all-wheel drive, is a direct competitor that we've yet to test. It might come close. Mercedes-AMG's launch control function is invitingly straightforward, from the driving mode switch to Sport, Sport Plus, or Race. Hold the brake with your left foot and press the accelerator until the revs stabilize at 4000 RPMs. When your left foot steps off the brake, the E63 rockets forward ahead of a wave of rippling V8 noise. Our test car's tailpipe music was enhanced by the $1,250 dual-mode AMG performance exhaust option. Some additional sound also is piped in through the speakers, but it sounds like a live recording of the actual engine, so we'll give that trickery a pass. Continue on to felonious speeds, and by 110 mph the E63 is reeled in by the Dodge and its advantageous power-to-weight ratio. After that, the Hellcat nits the E63 by mere tenths all the way up to 170 mph. Both cars are among the rarefied few, Lamborghini's Huracan supercar among them, capable of accelerating past that speed and braking before running out of road, on the 1.6-mile straightaway where we conduct acceleration and braking evaluations. Our E63 did manage to out-awesome the Charger's 13 mpg fuel economy, averaging a profligate 12 mpg overall during our test. As it did with previous E63s, Mercedes-AMG wraps the new model's rage in discreet and upscale clothing. It's the automotive equivalent of Daniel Craig's James Bond, an anger management headcase in a tuxedo. Aside from its burbling quad exhaust pipes, wide mouth front air intakes, and our test car's $1,700 black-painted forged aluminum wheels, the E63 looks like any other E-Class or, depending on the viewer's distance, any Mercedes C or S-Class. Until it kicks you in the face. There is the matter of the immoderate price. The AMG is $36,305 dearer than a Dodge Charger Hellcat and a $16,905 leap above a Cadillac CTS-V. Our test car's additional $29,935 in extras elevated the total cost to $135,330. Call it justified, though, as this counts as downright cheap for a machine capable of reaching 60 mph so quickly, not to mention doing so many other things well. Alternatives include the $135,000 Tesla Model S P100D and the $151,050 Porsche Panamera Turbo. Price notwithstanding, if you could own just one vehicle, this would be a good choice. Plus, there's a wagon version.